हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ पूजा शर्मा. दिस इज़ क्लास 10th ज्योग्राफी लेसन 6 मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्री. इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस फ्रीक्वेंटली आस्क क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द क्वेश्चन 1, दैट इज़ व्हाट इज़ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग. डिस्क्राइब द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग. सो प्रोडक्शन ऑफ गुड्स इन लार्ज quantities after processing from raw material to more valuable product is called manufacturing. Now what are the importance of manufacturing? Manufacturing industries help in modernizing agriculture. Okay, so it modernizing the agriculture means our primary sector is modernized by manufacturing sector. It reduces the heavy dependency of of people on agriculture income by providing them jobs in secondary and tertiary sector. It eradicates unemployment and poverty from our country. It also bring down regional disparities by establishing industries in tribal and backward areas. Export of manufactured goods expand trade and commerce and bring in much needed foreign exchange. In manufacturing, raw material are transformed into a wide varieties of finished goods which are of higher value. So our next question is, what is the economic strength of a country measured by the development of manufacturing industries? Explain this. So the economic strength of a country is measured by the development of manufacturing industry. Industry provide jobs in secondary and the tertiary sector, thus reducing dependency of people on agriculture. Industrialization helps to eradicate poverty and employment. Export of manufactured goods brings in much needed foreign exchange. Industries transform the raw material into a variety of goods of higher value. Most of the developed nations such as Japan, US are industrialized. That's why you can say these are the economic strength of the country that measured the development by the manufacturing industry. Now our next question is, agriculture and industry are complementary to each other. Means these are the different sectors, but they are complementary to each other. How? Explain it. So agriculture industry are not exclusive of each other. They move hand in hand. The agro-based industries have given a major boost to agricultural by raising its productivity. And the agro-based industries depend on agriculture for raw material. Manufacturing industries sell their product such as fertilizers, anticides, irrigations, pumps, PVC pipes, machines and tools. So to the farmers. Thus development and competitiveness of manufacturing industry has not only sustains agriculturists in increases their product but also made production process very efficient. Okay, so now our fourth question is, what is the importance of industries in economic development? So now we will talk about the importance of industry. Industry refers to the production of goods and related services within an economy. Industries play an important role in the economic development of any nation. Without industries, economic development is impossible. We can't imagine development without industry. So industries provide job in secondary and tertiary sector, thus reducing dependency of working people on agriculture sector. Industry help to reduce poverty and unemployment also. It transform the raw material into the variety of goods also. So these are the importance of industry in the economic development. Now our next question is, explain the factor that influence the location of an industry. If any industry wants to locate in any area, that time what the things we need to keep in mind. So that is, first is availability of raw material. the factory needs to be close to the location of raw material if they are heavy and bulky to transport, like example iron and steel and cement industries are located near the source of raw material, it cuts down the cost of transportation. And second thing is the labor. A large and cheap labor force is required for labor intensive manufacturing industries. High tech industries have to locate where suitable skilled workers are available. Third thing is power. Power supply is needed for working of the machines in a factory. Earlier industries were near to coal fields only. Today electricity allows more freedom to the industries. Fourth, that is capital. This is the money that is invested to start the business. The amount of capital will determine the size and location of the factory and transport. Fifth thing is required, that is transport. A good transport network helps to reduce cost and made the movement of raw material and finished goods easier. And sixth required thing is market. An accessible place to sell the product is essential part in the location of industry. And the last thing, that seventh, that is government policies. Industrial development is encouraged in some areas and restricted in others. Industries that are located in deprived areas may receive financial incentives and assistance from the government in the form of low rent and tax rebates. So these are the required things that is influence the location of an industry. Sixth question is classification of industry. So if we classify the industry, that is classification can be five ways. So first is on the basis of source of raw material. Second is according to their main role. Third is on the basis of capital investment. Fourth is on the basis of ownership. And fifth is based on the bulk and weight of raw material and finished goods. So let's start with the on the basis of source of raw material. Source of raw material, it is two: agro-based industry and mineral-based industry. In agro-based industry, cotton, woolen, jute, silk, textile, rubber and sugar, tea, coffee, edible oil, though these are comes in the agro-based industry, which get all the raw material from agriculture. So that is agro-based industry. Second is mineral-based industry, that is iron and steel, cement, aluminium, machine, tools, petrochemicals. These are mineral-based industry which provide raw material from minerals. Second classification is according to their main role. So that is two. One is basic industry and second is consumer industry. Basic industries are industry which supply their product or raw material to manufacture their goods, like iron and steel and copper smelting, aluminium smelting. These are basic industry. Consumer industries are that produce goods for direct use of consumer, like sugar, toothpaste, paper, sewing machine, fans. These are the industries which is directly used by the consumer. But we can see the basic industry, the iron, steel and copper smelting, aluminum smelting, it is not directly used by the consumer. So that is different from the basic industry. Now third classification is on the basis of capital investment. According to the capital investment, it is that is a small scale industry is defined that reference to the maximum investment allow on the asset of a unit. This limits has changed over a period of time. At present, the maximum investment allowed in rupees 1 crore. And according to the large scale industry, in that investment is more than 1 crore, that is large scale industry. नाउ अवर फोर्थ क्लासिफिकेशन इज ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ ऑनरशिप. ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ ऑनरशिप इट इज डिवाइडेड इन फोर. फर्स्ट इज पब्लिक सेक्टर एंड दैट ओन एंड ऑपरेट बाय द गवर्नमेंट एजेंसीज लाइक BHEL, SAIL, SAIL, etc. Second type, that is private sector industry, that is owned by the individuals or group of individuals like Bajaj Auto Mobiles, Dabur factories, Amul factories. So these are the private sector industries. And third type is joint sector industry, which are jointly run by the state and individuals or a group of individuals, like Oil India Limited is jointly owned by public and private sector both. Fourth type on the basis of ownership is cooperative sector industry, that is owned by producers or suppliers of raw material, workers or both. And they pool in the resources and share the profit or losses proportionately, and such as the sugar industry in Maharashtra and coal industry in Kerala. So these are the cooperative sector. They are investment cooperatively, and if any losses also there, so they will divide that losses also there. And the last classification, that is on the basis of bulk and weight, that is heavy industry and light industry. Heavy industry like iron and steel, these are the heavy industries, and light industries are there that use light raw materials and produce light goods, such as electrical industry. So these are light industry. Now our next question is, textile industry occupies a unique position in Indian economy. Support the statement with appropriate argument. So in that we will discuss about the textile industry. So textile industry is the second largest after agriculture due to some reason. That is, textile industry contributes significantly to industrial product, about 13%. It generates more employment, like 35 million. 35 million. Its foreign exchange earning are about 24.6%. It contributes 4% to our gross domestic product GDP. It is the only industry in the country which is self relevant. And cotton textile industries has a close link with agriculture and provides a link to farmers and cotton ball pluckers. It also support workers engaged in ginning, spinning, weaving, dyeing, designing, packaging, tailoring and sewing. The industry, by creating demands, support many other industries such as chemicals and dyes and meal stores, packaging material and engineering works. So textile industry occupies a unique position in Indian economy. So now describe the problems faced by cotton textile industry. Cotton textile industry face some problem also. A major loopholes, it huge fragmentation industry structure. It led by small scale companies. The industry's veterans portrayed the present productivity of factories at as low as 1/3 of level, which might be attended, and machinery is obsolete. It need to be upgraded in the heavy and processing sector in the particulars. There is a stiff competition with the synthetic fiber industry, which are available comparatively in a cheaper rate also. Power supply is erratic in our country. We are not have a proper power supply. So these are the problems or challenges that is faced by cotton textile industry in our country. Now our next question is, why is jute textile industry mainly concentrated in Hooghly Basin? एक्सप्लेन विद द रीजन. सो वी कैन सी दैट जूट टेक्सटाइल इंडस्ट्री इज मेनली कंसेंट्रेटेड इन हुगली बेसिन. दैट जूट प्रोड्यूसिंग एरियाज आर नियरर टू हुगली बेसिन. देर इज अ गुड नेटवर्क ऑफ रिवर्स विच प्रोवाइडेड इन एक्सपेंसिव वाटर ट्रांसपोर्ट एंड अबेंडेड वाटर सप्लाई फॉर जूट प्रोसेसिंग. गुड नेटवर्क ऑफ रेलवेज एंड रोडवेज फैसिलिटीज. द सप्लाई ऑफ रॉ मटीरियल टू द मील्स एंड फिनिश गुड टू द मार्केट. चीप लेबर इज अवेलेबल देयर फ्रॉम वेस्ट बंगाल एंड सम जॉइनिंग स्टेट्स ऑफ बिहार, उड़ीसा, उत्तर प्रदेश. कोलकाता इज अ लार्ज अर्बन सेंटर विच प्रोवाइड्स बैंकिंग, इंश्योरेंस और पोर्ट फैसिलिटीज फॉर द एक्सपोर्ट ऑफ द जूट गुड्स. दैट्स वाई मोस्ट ऑफ द जूट एंड टेक्सटाइल इंडस्ट्री इज कंसेंट्रेटेड इन हुगली बेसिन. Now our next question is, what challenges are faced by the jute textile industry in India and mention the main objective of National Jute Policy 2005. So challenges faced by the jute industry is there is a stiff competition in the international market from synthetic substitute. Competition from other competitors like Bangladesh is there, Brazil, Philippines, Egypt and Thailand. Some step has taken by the government to stimulate the demand of jute. The government policy of mandatory use of jute is packaging increase the internal demand. National Jute Policy 2005 was formulated with the objective of increasing productivity, improving quality, ensuring good prices to the jute farmers and enhancing yield per hectare. So these are the objectives of National Jute Policy that is started in 2005. Now our 11th question is, why is there a tendency for the sugar mills industry in southern state, southern and western state in India? So the sugarcane produced in the southern and western state has a higher sucrose content. The cooler climate ensure a longer crushing season. Most of the sugar mills of the area are under the cooperative sector. Regular supply of raw material is available there. Moreover, cooperatives are more successful in this area. More government attention for sugar production. There is better port facility in southern and the western state. That's why sugar mills are mostly shifted in the southern and the western state. Okay, so our next question is, explain the characteristics of information technology and electronic industry of India. So the characteristics of information technology is that a major impact of this industry has been on employment generation. This industry had been a major foreign exchange earner in the last 2 or 3 years because of its fast growing business process, outsourcing BPO sector, and the continuing growth in the hardware and software manufacturing is the key to the success of IT industry in India. The electronic industries cover a wide range of products from transistors set to television, telephones, cellular, telecom, radars, computers, etc. and many other equipments required by the telecommunication industry. Mumbai, Delhi, Hyderabad, Pune, Chennai, Kolkata, Lucknow and Coimbatore are the important center for electronic goods. Now our second last question, 13th, is India is an important iron and steel producing country in the world. Yet we are not able to perform to our full potential. So why this is, explain the reason. So high cost and limited availability of cooking coal, as the amount of coal is limited, its cost in India is high, and so iron and steel industry face difficulty in buying it. लो प्रोडक्टिविटी ऑफ लेबर ऑल्सो, द लेबर्स आर लेस प्रोडक्टिव, इरेगुलर सप्लाई ऑफ एनर्जी, देर इज़ एन इरेगुलर सप्लाई ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इन इंडिया, सो द वर्क बिकम्स मोर डिफिकल्ट, पुअर इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर, दैट द टेक्नोलॉजिकल डेवलपमेंट इन इंडिया इज कंपेरेटिवली लेस compared to other countries, research and development, there is a need to allocate resources for research and development to produce steel more comparatively, to raise their standard to meet international levels. And our last question of this chapter, that is 14, explain the importance of automobile industry in India. With the development of automobile industry in India, that is truck, buses, cars, motorcycles, scooters, three-wheelers, and multi-utility vehicles are being manufactured at various centers. They provide quick transport of goods and passengers. After the liberalization, the coming in of new and contemporary models, it stimulated the demand for vehicles in the market, which led to the healthy growth of industry, including passenger cars, two and three wheelers. Foreign direct investment brought in a new technology and aligned the industry with global development. So these are the importance of automobile industry in our country, India. So I hope all the important question of this chapter is clear. Thank you, everyone.